Thanks very much, Clarence Mason. Quite a man, I guess. But, well, what an impact Razor Ramon has made here recently. I tell you.
Cross, what is this? Come on.
Well, it's as an athlete that is 6 feet seven, close to 300 pounds. Hey, this guy can't help it that he looks like a movie star. This guy can't help it that he's a thoroughbred. And for people with a plow horse mentality can't understand this guy, that's their problem. You know, it's not my problem that I'm recruiting great athletes to come to the World Wrestling
Federation. There's no doubt in my mind that he's a great athlete. He's here in the World Wrestling Federation.
And perfect, even though he's not perfect, isn't this the bottom line? That they're bringing great athletes to the World Wrestling Federation?
Yeah, I'll agree with you, yes.
This company is all about competition.
No doubt about it.
And if it was entirely up to Vince McMahon, would have probably 30 clowns on the roster. You could have a Doink, a Dink, a Dank, a Duke, you know, the whole nine yards.
Well, instead he's got Mr. Perfect, Bret Hart, Stone Cold, Shawn Michaels. We got the greatest athletes in the world right here in the World Wrestling Federation. I should know I'm perfect.
I rest my case. Razor Ramon and the two sports star Bob Holly.
Who's a great athlete, by it?
He really is. Bob Holly's a great competitor. Certainly, Bob Holly, I know, will be traveling to Indianapolis. That's got to be one of his favorite cities. Holly, an avid race car aficionado. Of course, the Indianapolis, the home of the Indy 500. Razor Ramon. Sir, been hanging pretty closely with Big Daddy Cool Diesel in recent days since they both arrived here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Inseparable.
Gotta wonder. I never did really find out why Razor and Diesel were looking on in the aisle last Monday on Raw during that big melee involving Shawn Michaels and Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Well, they're taking a look at all the great competition here. They know sooner or later, if they work their way up, they get a shot at the top dogs here in the World Wrestling Federation.
We can see that Bob Holly's got a lot of competitive spirit, blatantly breaking the rules, pulling the hair, and then nailing Razor Ramon with a right hand. I can't wait to hear what Bret Hart's going to say tomorrow night on Raw. Fort Wayne, Indiana is going to be so electric tomorrow night. But I'm sure that Vince McMahon will be the one that'll do the interview instead of me, the one that's bringing Bret Hart back to the WWF.
And you bet I won't be any talking. I'll be all action, Ross, when it comes to Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
I can't wait to be sitting right there at ringside calling your match. I know the holes. McMahon hasn't learned a new hole in 25 years. Oh, what a move. Oh, my.
I mean, you know, Jim Ross, when I was in the ring wrestling, you never did the color commentary for one of my matches.
Oh, it's before my...
I hope you can keep up with it.
I'll try. I'm prepared for you.
In fact, I'd rather have you do it than McMahon. I think you have a better chance of keeping up with... I move so fast, so quick.
I think most of the athletes here feel the same way. Bob Holly's got to mount some offense here. Razor Ramon looking pretty dominant. There's a hard Irish whip. And Holly's in trouble. Don't you go away. We'll be right back. Razor with a suplex, and Holly is in more trouble. Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for being with us here this morning. Jim Ross and Mr. Perfect with you. We'll go back to Doc Hendricks in Indianapolis before we sign off here this morning. And the bad guy looking pretty good here today, Perfect.
No doubt about it. He's taking his time out there. Each move he's got, his timing looks, well, it's not perfect, but it's pretty good.
Nice sound strategy here by Razor Ramon, and Bob Holly again trying to free himself from this predicament. Well, I'll tell you something, my heart is beating faster and faster thinking about tonight's pay-per-view matchup. You know, I want to ask McMahon, man to man, face to face, why he shirked his responsibility and didn't sanction. Oh my, wait a minute, inside cradle. Almost a three count there by the pugnacious Bob Holly.
So what about McMahon now? What are you talking about?
Well, you know, it's non-sanctioned to the Buried Alive match. Hey, we don't want anything to do with it. We'll take the money, but we don't want any responsibility. Fall away slam. That is vintage Razor Ramon. 6'7", close to the 300-pound mark, as we mentioned earlier. Certainly has a lot of quickness. And now, Bob Holly is, he may be entering dead man's curve here.
Uh-huh. That away.
Holly's a competitor, I'll tell you that. Bob Holly is pound for pound one of the toughest men that you'll ever see, I can tell you that. And there's an inverted atomic drop. And Holly with a high impact clothesline.
Come on.
building some momentum here.
Bob Holly, two sport athlete, right? How about Mr. Perfect, 100 sport athlete? Imagine when I get back in the ring tomorrow night, Ross. Now that was great.
Great drop kick right on the jaw.
That could do it.
One, two, and a half. A long, long two count for Bob Holly on Razor Ramon. And there's a hurricanrana and a lateral press and another near fall.
Razor Ramon's in trouble here, Ross.
He really is. Think McMahon would know what that move is? He would say, oh, my. What a move. Oh, my. What a move. Let's get you ready for tonight, folks. I don't know why I'm not doing the play-by-play. I know the fans would rather have me doing the play-by-play as McMahon, but when you own the company, you can do any damn thing you want. That's just the way that it is.
I've been through that in my life, believe me, before. I used to work for the Ganyas.
Rich people get all the breaks. Suplex off the top. Old Bob Holly folded up like the proverbial accordion. And the end may be near.
We're going to get the sign from Razor, I think, right here. That's it.
You know, another thing about this guy, he's young. He's young. I mean, he's got a great career ahead of him. Razor's Edge. Why not?
Why not?
It's Sunday morning. No better time for the Razor's Edge. Bob Holly may dispute that point. And down he comes. Well, their picture's worth a thousand words.
I wouldn't mind giving Bob Holly some advice. You know, like I did Merrill. I think Holly has potential.
Well, you've helped Merrill. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, yeah.
Mark Merrill's a great intercontinental champ. Maybe not for long. Let's take another look. Nice move here. How would you describe this?
Well, if you take a good close look at it off the top rope, boom, right on the back of the head of Bob Holly, the Razor's Edge, forget about it. This one.